So, time for another product review, which we got two SSDs, but the version that I got is the 500 gigabytes, and the other one is a terabyte. Alright, so hello everyone, this is VlogWithAvroTF. Today I'll be unboxing one of these two SSDs that I got from Walmart. That's right, two SSDs. The version that I got for the red is 500 gigabytes. The version for the blue is a terabyte. It may come in different colors though, and different size types. For the 500 gigabyte, it only costs around $35 at the store. And the other one for the terabyte actually costs almost $90, literally. This is basically more than the double the amount for this solid state drive, the 500 gigabyte. Besides that, all the packaging itself looks pretty nice with some of the warranties, the back, and how this works with the dimensions as well. As same thing for the other one. Alright, let's just unbox this thing first. I just have to peel the tape before I record anything though. But look at all those contents in there. Let's take them out. Oh, it's just a box itself, okay. Now let's just open this case. Ooh, it's almost like a... This piece is almost like a smallest solid-state drive I've ever seen with the red one. Let's just set it down nice and carefully, no accidental drops or anything. Open other contents in there too. Yeah, there's some contents that I haven't pulled everything out, but let me just see if I can get these bad boys out. Oh, just have to open the side like this instead of that. But let me open the other side. Let's see. Get that thing out of here. Yeah, that's how it's open. So it does have two cables. USB-C to USB-C, USB-C to USB-A, which I can only access it using my iPad Pro that also comes with the USB-C. But here they are. We've got like two cables, USB-C, USB-C, USB-C to the USB-A adapter, and we got this instructions manual. The portable SSD, which you can use it to connect to your phone to store your files, or you could just simply plug it to your computer and that's all. But not counting with my iPad Pro, I don't think any of my devices can carry USB-Cs, so I'm not sure what to do with these here, but it will work for my iPad Pro and my laptop that has a USB-C port. So of course, this quality, the Samsung, yeah, which is very prone to drop risks. It's a pretty small device, almost like two times smaller than my phone itself. Yeah, it's like holding a flip phone. If I compare the size of holding this small SSD, it's basically almost holding like four USB flash drives. Almost four flash drives that you can carry. This solid-state drive is even smaller than my iPhone 14 Pro that I have. Overall, this can be used for like personal storage purposes of any kind, such as getting almost some of my content safe here. But looking at the side, also displays a label, which is currently 500 gigabytes. I don't know if you guys see it, but this camera is bad at focusing some of the labels despite holding it at the careful distance. So that's the best shot I can get out of that. Let's just set this aside as well. And now we open this 1 terabyte storage that I can use for other storage purposes. Now I just got that one open. Let's just dump this out of the box here with the same packaging design. Let's just open that. Here it is, the blue Samsung device. Also, the cables came in the same way as I unboxed with the same SSD as well. So yeah, this is the opposite color, which I got the blue variant for a terabyte as well. But the text is a little different here, which is a terabyte, So I can use it to store almost most of my gaming or video content that infamously stored a lot. The reason why I'm buying this is that my PC cannot handle that much storage, so I had to temporarily use a CD-ROM, which happens to be right next to me, as a simple 4GB storage per dish. The reason why I store lots of CD-ROMs to archive all my files and even some of my vlogging content is that my USB flash drives that I use for other content does not store up to 4GB due to the EXFAT32 setting. Before I got these SSDs, I normally store most of my videos into a CD-ROM, which is very inconvenient for me and it would take up a lot of paper to wrap everything and then store them in a small container as of now. Some of the benefits were that I can use it to store file by file contents into a dish. I can only store up to 4GB at max capacity. If I store way more than the amount needed, it will corrupt the dish. This has happened to one of my previous vlogging videos that had a corrupted dish. If you want to check out my previous video that I showed of how I lost some of the files for vlog, whatever that number is, yeah, check it out. But of course, I retain most of the files itself though, even though I now learned how to just simply copy everything and then paste them into a dish instead of just moving them directly. Otherwise, I lose access to all the files. Another downside is that once it's written, it will be permanently written on the dish and it cannot be removed at any given amount of time. So it will stay like that for the rest. So overall for the dish, now that I got all the SSDs, I would save it for like writing down or setting up a video recording of that as well. Or just a simple video editing, or I'm not even sure. Now I know I get lost in some cases here, but to summarize it, in other words, I would save these dishes out of some other video projects that I can demonstrate or burn it into a DVD and then just showcase them by dish. Yeah, even though I now have a few amount of CD or DVD ROMs left, actually it's a DVD ROM, I would have to save up something else. And yes, if you're guessing what that is, and yes, that's just my Walmart receipt for all these purchases. Alright, with that being said, let's test each of those devices and see which and how they perform. Even though I got like four cables with two being the exact same kind, like the USB-C and USB-A, I'll just put at least one of them in case if I needed those cables in the future. So I'll use only the two cables that provided. Just realized that even though I do have the USB-C to Lightning adapter, every time I plug into both of my devices at the same time, this apparently doesn't show up on my phone for some reason, and nothing starts blinking on these hard drives. So maybe I do have an incompatible cable that doesn't seem to recognize it clearly or something, not sure. Apparently, I would have gotten that Lightning to USB 3 camera adapter for this, but this cable doesn't directly connect with the solid-state drive at the moment as of now, so I may not be able to get a chance to test it. Alright, now I have this set up for the test here. So let's just give this red 500GB SSD a try. Right now I'm just going to use those USB-C cables which came with my for my port. So here it is, plugging it in, and the other one too, except it's facing the other one. There, make sure it snaps. Now, the Samsung is connected to my computer already. So for this section here, this T7 has been added into this drive already, so it shows setup, portable, everything as well. So yeah, it came with the app itself for that. But I'm gonna keep that inside in case if I needed it. But let's give it a setup. Uh-oh, something's wrong with it. Let me just temporarily turn it off. Seems like the computer has crashed itself when trying to open files. Alright, let's give it a second try. Excuse me for a second. Alright, so done with the setup, but just only in private though. And so, let's give it a test. Oh great, there's another message that appeared for the Samsung magician that appeared. Yeah, I would need a firmware update for this device. It failed to update? Okay. And maybe next time. Alright, so I'm just gonna resume the test here as of now. But here's the status that I got from the portal SSD. So everything looks good and pretty working temperature at the best here. But of course, I haven't read anything for that portable SSD here. So of course, I have this set up as well. But everything looks pretty good. Alright, so I already clicked on play just to test out this read and write speed for this 500GB SSD. Right now it's still in the testing phase here, but we got the read and write speeds showing on the results on the screen here as well, but everything should look pretty well. After waiting to complete the test for the 500GB SSD, the results came closer to 1GB per second. I also performed some additional testing results through the Samsung Magician app with the benchmark displaying similar results as the crystal dish. The quick diagnostic tests also showed no bad sectors within the hard drive itself. Alright, so yeah, just a very quick test. I won't do a full test anyway, but let's just test the other one for this blue SSD that has a terabyte. So let's give it a shot. Alright, now that it's plugged in, let's just give it another try for this other SSD.
Here we are back end, just naming the new SSD. So I'm just going to use this one. Alright, so downloading the files right now and updating the firmware. I forgot to record this, but I've now updated this blue SSD to the current firmware as of now. Oh yeah, it also appears as the same name as my red SSD, but I'm just gonna have to name it something else then. But of course, it now has almost a terabyte storage that I can use to store all my videos. After going through another test run, the results displayed similar statistics like the red SSD for the blue terabyte SSD. This is true when going through Samsung Magician app and having clean sectors.
Yes, I know this is just a very quick test and not an entirely full test though. But of course, all these hard drives should work just fine, or the solid state drives, of course. So what am I going to do with it? Well, once again, I could use these solid state drives to store most of my project files if I can. But let's just unplug it for now since I'm done using it. Alright, so just one side note is that I've already completed the firmware update for the red SSD, which is the 500GB. So of course, that's basically it for now. Alright, so here's the final test for this blue storage, or this external SSD that I have plugged in. So let's give it a test. Oh, I see it. It's copying files a lot quicker. Oh man, but it can only copy up to 523 megabits, because my... There we go. It works. So far, I do have pasted the VlogWithAvroTF file, which is my Sonic the Hedgehog collection, if you would like to check out the video as well. But this is just a brief test. Alright, so now, this is the second test of me copying into the red SSD. Let's give it a shot. That is very quick. I can't believe it's that fast to copy and paste everything in just one go. So I'm glad I love it. Alright, just simply delete the file. Don't worry, I have it backed up already, so we just simply hit delete, and it'll just go into the bin. Alright, testing done. No further questions.
Alright, so yeah, I know this is a ridiculously short review of me unboxing and testing each of those SSDs, of course. But overall, everything works just fine. I could use it to store all my projects and everything else for all my vlogging videos and other content gaming as well. So, of course, that's basically everything I have. If you guys do enjoy my content, please consider following me on other social media platforms, my about page. This is VlogWithAvroTF, signing out.